On this feast of Christ the King, we welcome one and all to our celebration of the Eucharist here in the community of St. Joseph. My name is Scott Gordon, and leading us in prayer today is Father Steve. Deacon John Manera will offer the homily today. Joining us today at Mass are Chuck and Diane Bilshevsky, who are celebrating their 50th wedding anniversary. We extend a special welcome to the Bilshevsky family and their guests. We celebrate today the unending reign of a king who has no crown, but a crown of thorns, and no throne, but the cross. We proclaim Jesus Christ as our King, who came to establish the peace and love of the kingdom of God. As we begin our worship, let us raise our voices in praise of God with the song, "To Jesus Christ, our Sovereign King," found in your program. But first, let us rise to greet one another as our custom.
The Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, on this Thanksgiving weekend, we come to our Heavenly Father's house, offering him praise and worship. We come acknowledging that Christ is truly our King. We come knowing that the Lord desires to give us all that we need. Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, in your kingdom you have dominion, glory, and kingship. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the Alpha and the Omega, the origin and destiny of all creation. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you were born into this world, King, to testify to the truth. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
We praise you, we bless you.
us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whose will is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of the universe, grant, we pray, that the whole creation, set free from slavery, may render your majesty service and ceaselessly proclaim your praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the ancient one and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingdom shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
He is robed in majesty. The Lord is King. He is robed in majesty. The Lord is King in splendor robed. Robed is the Lord and girt about with strength. The Lord is King, he is robed in majesty, and he has made the world firm, not to be moved. Your throne stands firm from of old, from everlasting you are, O Lord. The Lord is King, he is robed in majesty. Your decrees are worthy of trust indeed. Holiness befits your house, O Lord, for length of days. The Lord is King, he is robed in majesty.
A reading from the book of Revelation. Jesus Christ is the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood, who has made us into a kingdom, priests for his God and Father, to him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he is coming amid the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. All the peoples of the earth will lament him. Yes, amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, the one who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
You have the words, you have the words of everlasting life.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Pilate said to Jesus, "Are you the King of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you say this on your own, or have others told you about me?" Pilate answered, "I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom does not belong to this world. If my kingdom did belong to this world, my attendants would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not here." So Pilate said to him, "Then you are a king." Jesus answered, "You say I'm a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." The Gospel of the Lord. Feast of Christ the King. It lands at a very interesting part in the calendar year. This is actually the last Sunday before a brand new calendar year. And here we are professing Jesus Christ as King of not only of what's heaven and what's in heaven, but also what is here on earth. Its origins really aren't that long ago. In December of 1925, Pope Pius XI decided that he was going to proclaim that in the church calendar there would be something called Feast of Christ the King. And it was an interesting period in 1925. It followed World War I and all the problems and sufferings that happened as a result of it. And it was at that time still prior to the great fall of the Great Depression in 1930s. And to read from the encyclical, which is called Qs Primus, the Feast of Christ the King, there was a couple of things in there that he had in his mind that I thought would be appropriate that could help us today. He observed that a majority of the people had pushed Jesus Christ and his holy law out of their lives, and it had no place in either private affairs or in politics. He went on to say that as long as individuals and states refuse to submit to the authority of our Savior, there would be no real hopeful prospect of lasting peace among the nations. Men must look for the peace of Christ in the kingdom of Christ. Begs the question, how do we do that? How do we seek out Christ and enter into a deeper relationship with Him? Well, we have the gifts of the sacraments here. By virtue of attending Mass and the prayers that we say, this is all opportunities for us to enter into a deeper and relationship with Him. But we have another opportunity, and this year has been deemed the year of faith. And it has very similar attributes to it. As Pope Benedict proclaimed this year as the year of faith, one of the things that we are trying to do this year is to regenerate, rejuvenate, bring forth a more deeper and loving relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ. And we do it in the midst of turmoil. We do it in the midst of political turmoil, human suffering, and a lot of unsurety. Today's gospel talks about Christ and his kingly authority and truth. And it is those two things that I want to focus on as we try to talk a little bit about how we come closer to regenerating our faith and becoming more loving towards Christ. You see, it's very interesting in this gospel reading. Jesus is brought before Pilate and is accused of political treason. And the treason that he was accused of was a crime punishable by death. And Jesus turns the focus after the accusations are leveled against him. In the particular gospel reading, Pilate is asking Jesus, is he a king? Thinking king here on earth, thinking of the earthly domain. And what does Christ do? He tries to elevate the conversation. He tries to help Pilate ascend to where Christ is and says, my kingdom is not of this world, but is a kingly world of the spiritual realm, of the realm that is not here, the everlasting realm, which is what Christ was talking about. In the last part of that scripture passage, just before the gospel actually stops, it's one of the most famous lines that Pilate asks. When Jesus says, everyone who is of truth hears my voice, Pilate said to him, quid est veritas? What is truth? What a great question. What is truth? Especially in the turmoil that we're dealing with. Who knows anymore on TV who's speaking the truth? Whether you're from the left or the right, everybody is taking some little piece of truth and twisting it. Who can we rely on that can give us the truth to live the life that we're intended to live? Well, we get some insight in today's feast. Christ is the king. He is the authority. But we don't like that word authority too much. I'm on the tail end of a generation that did nothing but buck authority. And I see from some of the gray hair, there's a few of you in the crowd. And it's a challenge for us. And it's okay to question authority if you're seeking out to try to find the truth that lies behind it. The word authority itself can conjure up things of, you know, images of overbearing dictators, individuals barking out orders and restrictions to personal freedom. And unfortunately, I've talked to a lot of fallen away Catholics, and the way that they look at the Catholic Church is that there's too many rules, too many things that I have to follow. We struggle with authority. But I want to give you a little bit different perspective on authority. I was debating whether to use a prop, but I thought it'd be a good idea, just to make the point. Y'all recognize this? What is it? FedEx. How many times in your life have you seen this? Do you know what this company does, right? It delivers things very quickly, very promptly. Would you consider yourself an expert on Federal Express to the degree that anybody could be that's not working at the company? Could you say that you've seen this sign over 100 times? So we're comfortable with what this particular sign basically says. We've come to a good understanding of it. And we've lived with it on a day-to-day basis. And as trucks pass by, we kind of say, okay, I know what they're doing. There's an interesting aspect of this sign. I've been involved in product marketing, and one of the things that I've discovered in product marketing is that I read an article that basically talked about the individual who helped design this particular logo. And hidden within this logo, this is going to change your life. It will never be the same after today, I guarantee it. Hidden in this logo is an arrow. And that arrow is meant to signify rapid deployment, rapid delivery of things. So I present this to you in the case of, here you are, you were comfortable with the definition of what this logo basically meant, and yet there was something hidden in that logo that makes it more rich than what you ever knew before. And it took authority, an authority figure, to basically reveal that. Is that any different than what our faith is? How many times have we become comfortable with what it is that we've heard on a day-to-day basis. I fall into it every day. It took me 5 years of formation to help me get out of my rut in the faith. And the way that you find the deep, the depth and coming close to others, individuals, is by listening and dealing with the authority. Now, we're very fortunate in our lives because our authority comes to us in a couple different ways. The obvious authority is Christ the King. Christ is the Word. He's the Word of God made flesh. And so the primary authority that we can focus on and can depend on and know that it's true is Christ himself. Why? Because he said so. I'm the way, I'm the truth, I'm the life. And if he was wrong, then we're all wasting our time here. But he was not wrong. He was speaking the truth. He was speaking the truth. He was right in front of Pilate when Pilate asked him, what is truth? Why couldn't Pilate see him? Why couldn't Pilate recognize that this man was truth in itself embodied? Many times we are blinded to the truth. And it takes a seeking and asking the hard questions about what truth is. And getting that information back from authority. So the primary way that we can get truth is through the Word. When we, yeah, this is a Bible, by the way, in case you're wondering, I'm Catholic preaching. I actually have a Bible up here. It's okay to read the Bible. It's okay to mark it up and do things from it. We hear about the Word, and we automatically think that the Bible is the place for the Word. And we'd be partly right. You see, the Bible didn't come in until about mid-400 AD. Before that, people were relying on tradition and word of mouth and the things that Jesus Christ had taught and passed on to his people. So the second thing of authority that contains the Word God himself is sacred tradition. It's the traditions that we passed on to each other. It's the traditions that are determined by the church. And the third one is that we can rely upon the teaching arm of the Catholic Church, the magisterium, to basically help us understand all of these in concert with each other. If any one of those three things don't agree with each other, we don't have to believe it, because it's not completely true. All of those have to be in concert with each other. And so that's the litmus paper test that we are afforded as part of our, as part of our faith. Finally, we have to be disposed to receive the truth when we hear it. I'm a pretty stubborn guy, and it took me a long time through my formation process to get rid of the things that I thought were true and start following the things that I learned to be true based on the authority that I was hearing. And it wasn't God standing in the way, it wasn't the church standing in the way, it was me standing in the way. So in closing, we celebrate a wonderful feast today, a feast of Christ the King, and his authority, not only things here on earth, but things that are ultimate, our ultimate destiny and our spiritual world and kingdom, which he rules over. We also have the ability to know what is true by what he's passed down to us and the tools that the church has given us through the Word, through sacred tradition, and through the magisterium of the Catholic Church. And finally, the biggest challenge, I believe, is to challenge our hearts so that we are open to maybe get rid of the way that we thought of things when we hear truth being presented right in front of us. And so I think that's something that we can take away from us and try to live the rest of this week as we, and the rest of the year as we try to develop a more loving relationship towards our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Knowing that Jesus Christ, our King, has the authority to answer all the prayers that our hearts desire, we bring him our petitions now.
Let us pray for the church. God, you are the one who is, who was, and who is to come. May the church, your priestly people, be free from sin, full of love, and faithful in service. We pray to the Lord. Let us pray for God's grace to fill our world and all its peoples. Ruler of the universe, give wisdom to the world leaders and to our local officials. May your kingdom come and your love bring peace to our broken world. We pray to the Lord. Let us pray for the lowly and the poor. Jesus, you gave your life for everyone, for sinners and saints alike. In this Thanksgiving season, help us to open our hearts and minds to the needs of others. We pray to the Lord. Let us pray for the sick and those suffering the pain of loneliness. King of human hearts and souls, bring healing to our brothers and sisters. Denise Stearns, Ralph Richard, and all those who have asked for our prayers. We pray to the Lord. Let us remember the dead. Eternal King, may our beloved ones reign with you in glory. We remember in a special way Constance Harvey, Betty Scheid, Anne, Tommy, and Dr. Charles Caribo, and Joseph Boyvin. We pray to the Lord. Let us pray for our personal needs in a moment of silence. Good Shepherd and King, bring travelers safely to their destinations. Be with all of us on our life's journey. Keep our families close during the holidays. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Eternal Father, we bring to you all these needs that we have. We bring to you the deep desires and fears of our heart, knowing that you have the great desire to hear and answer our prayers, for we ask them through our eternal High King, through the King of heaven and earth, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Please join in our offertory hymn, The King of Love.
Pray, dearly beloved, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son himself may bestow on all nations the gifts of unity and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness as eternal priest and King of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption, and making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Joseph and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Benedict our Pope and Alan our Bishop, his assistant bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Oh.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, O Lord, that glorying in obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, we may live with him eternally in his heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
In your kindness, please remember the family of Constant Harvey, who died this past week. Mass of Christian burial was celebrated here for Mrs. Harvey on Friday. On December 8th, Brave Hearts will present Being a Man in the New Evangelization with speaker Greg Willits. Brave Hearts representatives will be available to register men for this event in Marion Hall after Mass today. If you missed the Advent Giving Tree in the gathering space last weekend, there are still many tags available if you wish to provide a gift for a needy person this Christmas. Father Mike will offer a presentation of his experiences in the Holy Land at Senior Coffee this Wednesday morning following the 9 o'clock Mass. All are welcome. And lastly, you will find Catholic wall calendars available at the church entryways, compliments of the Sparks Griffin Funeral Home in Lake Orion.
Our Wednesday morning senior coffee is a very misleading title. There's much more than just seniors there, although it's during the day, it's after the 9 a.m. Mass, so I know most people can't make it who work during the day. And there's a whole lot more than coffee. People make these pastries and these like egg dishes. There's a lot there. So if you're available Wednesday morning, I invite you to come by and hear about Father Mike's pilgrimage to the Holy Land. I'm going to ask Daniel and Owen to come with me for this blessing. For Chuck and Diane are celebrating their 50th wedding anniversary today. And so we're going to have a special blessing over Chuck and Diane here. I ask their family and friends are all here as well. So if you want to get a picture, you can come in the middle too, or wherever you'd like. 50 years, right? When's the date? Is today? Today, 50 years ago today. Was it a Saturday 50 years ago? It was? It's a long time ago. It was 60 degrees. Well, it's not 60 degrees today, so. Chuck, I ask you to repeat after me. It's Charles, right? I, Charles, reaffirm my marriage vows and rededicate myself in the same spirit that I pronounced when I took Diane, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death. I, Diane, reaffirm my marriage vows and rededicate myself in the same spirit that I pronounced when I took Charles, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death. Lord, reach out your hand to your faithful servants so that they may seek you wholeheartedly and receive from you all the good things they desire. Almighty God, look with blessing on this couple who have just renewed their marriage vows. They have come before your altar with happy hearts to offer their thanks to you. Grant that they may continue to live in genuine Christian love and attain with their family and friends the joys of many more years together. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Chuck, you may kiss your bride again. Congratulations. Fifty years, that's beautiful. Congratulations. We have a couple of young altar servers today who are celebrating birthdays. Owen, how old are you today? 10. And Daniel, how old are you?
11.
So happy birthday to Owen and to Daniel today. Please stand. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Let us go and live the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ to the world.
Thanks be to God.
Join in our closing hymn, Crown Him with Many Crowns.